I'd like you to meet somebody now who, although that we are a republic of proud of it, has some royalty. The lady that I have long admired. Put your hands together and welcome, with much travelled, much loved, Ireland's queen of country music,
Philomena Begley.
She arrives in all her splendour each night at 9 o'clock.
I can't understand why people can play ready country music. Every song that they sing, somebody along the way can identify with.
Country music has been good to Philomena Begley. For nearly 45 years, she has been one of its greatest champions, both at home and abroad. And as its long-reigning queen, she's loved every minute of it.
She's the queen of the silver dollar. She rules the smoking kingdom.
But like everyone, Philomena has had her share of heartaches along the way.
I got a phone call from Daddy since many months ago. I thought that it was the end of the world.
Through her songs, Philomena tells it like it is. Yet off stage, Ireland's hardest working star is slow to brag about her popularity.
Have you ever thought about why you have been so successful?
I never really thought about it, to be honest.
Can I answer for her?
Yeah.
How she's been so popular for so long. Mm. She's singing the music that people of Ireland like.
I suppose you could call me a workaholic. I took her to a bit of money. I'm sure I couldn't wait to get back.
God save the queen.
While taking a break at her holiday home in the seaside town of Bundoran, County Donegal, Philomena still finds it hard to resist the lure of the bright lights. Bundoran is a home from home for Philomena, whose life has always revolved around music.
Come on, how are you? I always loved singing from the very early days. My father was a great man for having to sing songs at home. So I suppose that's probably where it all came from.
But little did she dream back then that she would end up with a string of hits and thousands of devoted fans.
Well, this is where it all happens. Would you believe it? Imagine. I've even got my name in the lights.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's see you lift the roof of Queen of Country Music. Down there in Pinesley, Tyrone, the one and only Philomena Begley.
Since she was old enough to climb onto a stage.
We used to have run an odd concert that we used to think we were running these concerts in the barn at home, and there was a few of the girls who got together and we would get up and put a show on. We'd put curtains and all up, it would be in a hay loft. We would invite a few, but we didn't get too many to turn up. It was this old lady one time, and she was our only customer. We charged her a halfpenny. Well, that's got back a long enough time ago.
Like many of her generation who were faced with hard times, Philomena started work at an early age.
I left school on a Friday evening and I was 15 years of age, and I went to work in a ham factory in Cookstown, Fisher's Ham Factory. It wasn't compulsory really that time to go to the secondary school unless you were getting paid in, and at that time my parents wouldn't have been able to afford to pay any of us into schools. When I started on the Monday morning, it was like going to America. I was just going into a different world altogether because I was coming out of a wee village from Pomeroy, and I wouldn't have been much further than school and around Pomeroy.
It was Philomena's talent for singing, however, that was to take her far from her native County Tyrone.
I'm sitting in my English home, surrounded by your end.
I went to a Kelly in the local hall in Pomeroy. The girls that I was with, they sort of dared me to go up to sing, and I went up and I sang a couple of songs, and then a couple